Mallard. Purplish, blue, whatever you want to call it. Speculum, outlined in white. Black duck looks real similar, except for instead of outlined in white, it's outlined in black stripes. And typically it's a little darker overall. But the hen black ducks can be lighter too, resembling more of like the hen mallard. Let's see, you guys don't know wood duck. That's one you can take.
Dave isn't right there.
Where? Oh, I didn't even see that. Yeah.
Here's that part.
Wood ducks. Real iridescent in color.
White tips.
Got the white tips, and then one big thing about them, you flip them over, and the patterning on the back of your wood ducks.
I didn't even know that.
Let's see. Let's try to go in a certain order. Here's our pintail. Better pintail.
How many points is this final test?
100.
Okay.
Here's a pin. See you, Jacob. Come in and do duck wings if you want. There's pintails. They have like the bronze and the white. And it's kind of an iridescent, kind of like, depends on how you look at it. A lot of times it looks like a brown or a black, but in the right light conditions, it actually can look real green.
Mm-hmm.
Here's shovelers. And your shovelers have the blue shoulder patch.
Mm-hmm.
And then the green speculum. Here's your widgeon. And the big thing on the widgeon is the big white shoulder
mm-hmm.
patch on your widgeons. Gadwall.
There's crawling me.
Gadwall.
Okay.
Gaddies are real easy because it's the brown, black, white, brown, mm-hmm. black, white, the white window on the bottom. The only one that has a lot of white is the northern shoveler, but it's a white shoulder patch compared to, but main thing, brown, black, white.
I thought that
on
was
your
the
gadwall.
Widgeon.
Or widgeon. Yeah, shovelers.
Shovelers have a blue shoulder patch as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
I like a bigger version of the blue wing.
Yep. Yeah, and that's, there's a lot of lookalike, what is there? What happened to our shovelers? Oh, here.
I ate them.
There's kind of the lookalike ones, your blue-winged teal, and then your shoveler. They look similar, but shovelers is considered one of the big ducks. Teal are your smallest of your ducks, and generally, rule of thumb, a whole teal wing will fit in your hand where a shoveler will be larger than your hand just because teal are so small. And then, I know this doesn't really show it all that well, but in the breeding plumage, I think the green wing teal and the pintail look real similar. But once again, your pintail is one of your big ducks, your green wing teal. Small duck and the whole wing can fit in the palm of your hand, but the green speculum on them and the bronze just similar to the
Mm-hmm.
Pintail. Although I'm having a hard time getting the green.
You can see it under there. Oh well.
There. But it is darker, not as vivid as the green wing teal. And I think that's it, right? For the big or for dabblers.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of questions are you gonna ask us per the wings?
What
just
are they?
Just ID.
Not like
yeah, and then your divers, the easiest one is your smallest, is your tuxedo, the black and white, and that's your hooded merganser.
Now what's the format of the test? Like, do we all need to come in at once and take it at the same time, or can we kind of filter in?
You can filter in. And then your last two is your redhead and your canvas back.
Redhead ends with, like, darker tips.
Yeah, the easiest way I think of it is think of, like, art class or something. Think of a piece of canvas or a canvas tarp for camping. Or if you're an artist and you stretch canvas on a frame. You know how canvas has, like, that texturing to it?
Mm-hmm.
The canvas back has texturing. The redhead is solid. Mm-hmm. As far as the test goes, what it is it's half and half. Cough medicine.
Mm-hmm.
It's half and half. It'll be like 10 or 12 stations set up, and then the rest of it will be, you know, the 10 or 12 stations will have set up on two tables, and then you can sit down anywhere and answer the rest of the questions. Just kind of one word answers to a couple sentences to doing some of those math formulas and stuff like that. So it's not too bad, but it does get kind of crowded in here. So let's see, here's your class is at 2 o'clock. So if you
I usually get like half an hour before I come in because most people kind of start to filter out.
Yeah, so if any of you guys wanted to show up at like 2:30, 2:45 to take it, you can do that. We have till 5 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.